Good afternoon, everyone. So the subject we are going to discuss today is regarding business economics. Business economics generally deals with the production, manufacturing, supply, trade, or and with all the other elements related which are related to the business. So as future entrepreneurs and future managers of India, there is a need for us to learn business economics. We need to learn and understand business economics clearly. So in this process of learning, there might be several questions which arise with us, or there might be several questions which chase us in our thoughts. So today our professor Raju, Indukoori sir, is here with us to answer all our questions in this question and answer session. So I request Raju, Indukoori sir, along with Prabhu Charan, Pravallika, Teresa and Asha Ranija to take over the session.
Thank you. I'm glad that I'm connected to you all on this day. Gracing the occasion, I open this forum to my fellow students and others. Questions?
we have price rise and price fall graph. In that only negative slope we have there. At what instant we can observe positive slope in both price rise and price fall?
Okay, you mean to say the demand curve is negative. It has a negative slope. Is there any tendency that it has a positive slope?
In
both the cases, of course, then it becomes positive. I got your question. You can take it this way. When you take determinants of demand, there are a few determinants of demand which are very important. One is price of the product, second one is price of the other products, and third one is income. So in these three conditions, negative slope of demand does not exist. It depends. If it is price, absolutely price, demand, the slope of the demand is negative. And income elasticity of demand and movement of change in quantity demanded along with income, it is positive. And complementary and substitutes, they vary differently. But your question is, price of the same product, it moves up and demand goes up, right? It may happen with different goods or different paradigms, where like if you even price of precious metals, gold or alcoholic products, tobacco products or addictive products. In fact, food is also kind of addictive product for me. So when the price goes up, demand goes up, people will feel as if it will be out of the market for several years or for the entire future. They try to buy more when the price goes up.
As a student, as a management student, why we have to study business environment as a subject?
Which is a business economics. That's a good question. I don't know how many of you are aware of it. Why should you take this course, business economics? Economics is part of everyone's life. Forget about business economics. Economics is part of everyone's life. Let it be a student, faculty, homemaker, employee, businessman, a prime minister, an MLA, whoever. Because we are associated with money. If there is money, the scope for economics is there. If someone like cryptocurrency, something comes, a system comes where we all live without money, then there is no economics. So my point is, when economics is more important to us in a personal life, it will be obviously more important for business. So that's how all the business managers, business leaders, they try to get connected with business and through economics to maximize their profits. So that's how this course is offered. I hope I answered your question, Teresa.
Yes. How does supply and demand affect the GDP?
Supply and demand? I don't know how to answer this question. What do you feel? Why GDP increases? According to you, GDP may go up, GDP may come down. It is because of supply or demand? Okay, I think I don't want to stress you. When you take the supply function, more is the supply, more is the price. Higher the price, higher the supply, the other way. And if you take demand, higher the price, lower the quantity. So business expands, the quantity demanded increases. Not only that, the value of the product should also increase. You see Q1, Q2, Q3 or Q4 or annual results of a company. You say profits of some company have gone up. Recently I have seen Flipkart's profits, losses have increased. Amazon's losses have come down. So from 6,000 crores to 5,000 crores it has come down. But for Flipkart, the profits, losses have gone up. So every company tries to minimize the losses and maximize the profit. If that has to happen, the quantity should increase and the price should also be good. It is very tough. But in a competitive market, you cannot ride on high price. If it is a low competitive market and you have imperfect competitive market, yeah, any price is okay. But in a competitive market, high price doesn't work. So it all depends on whether supply is influencing GDP or demand is influencing GDP, because the price is the factor. Obviously, the demand is more, sales is more, as simple as that. That has a direct link between GDP and demand. Okay?
So what is the relation between business economics and other managerial functions?
So, business economics and managerial functions. Okay, here I need to, I think in the class, some of you are asking, business functions, in planning is one function of business management. You have staffing, you have coordinating, you have controlling. These are all the functions. So when you look at functions, the whole business management as a process, you have different functions which is split into different parts. In addition to that, the functional division or functional departments are there in business. Say IT department, finance function, sales department, sales function, marketing function, operation function, production function. Like that, different functions are there. So the importance of business economics or simply economics into these functions differ. For example, if you take finance function, finance and economics, they're together. You cannot differentiate both. As economics was derived from finance, it was derived out. Okay? And you cannot separate finance and economics. So that way, finance department is more related to business economics. And even other functions like marketing, HR, for example, if you say HR, when there is a cost minimization, how to cut the cost and how to increase the quantity of input, which is manpower. I think HR people have to break their heads. That's where you need business economics in different functions.
Sir, how can you differentiate business environment and economics environment?
Oh, that's a good one. Maybe you're having business environment and business economics, two subjects. That's a fantastic question. I never heard that question in my class. Thanks, Teresa, you asked me that right now. Business environment is all about every factor influencing business. Okay. When you say business environment, you have economic environment, financial environment, social environment, political environment, cultural, legal, anything. Anything is an environment. If it is an offshore business, doing business out of the country, and you have more environmental changes, which is very tough, very difficult to understand that. But in business economics, while doing business, you to maximize the profit, minimize the losses, okay, maximize the wealth, increase the wealth of the shareholders. These kind of things are there, which is more for a finance manager. So economics is related to decisions of the manager based on value, like whatever I told you. But in the case of business environment, it's all about doing business. If you want to start a business in UAE, for example, Dubai or Sharjah or Abu Dhabi, it is not the same doing business in Vishakhapatnam or Vizag or Bangalore or Hyderabad or Delhi or Bombay. It is completely different. So business economics is easy in both the places, but business environment is challenging. Got it? I hope I answered.
Yes, sir.
You can estimate the demand at any time. Why government failed during demonetization?
It was your question or others' question? Whose question is that? Where is Somnadh? Somnadh, can you show your face, please? Yeah, can you repeat the question, Somnadh?
At any point of time, you can estimate the demand of any kind of product or why government failed during the demonetization?
Thanks for asking that. So, this is a little out of the box, but still I answered that. Demonetization and economics. He says that everyone is very good in planning. Importantly, government bodies, they are very good in planning and executing the plan. And they have a very big team through, because they are powerful. They can do anything. They are powerful. That's what the objective is, to check people holding the black money. But the way they have implemented got the time delay. The objective is good. In many countries, it happens. Okay, it is good for every one of us. The purchasing power for illegal money is more because it's not seen. All the salaried people, honest business people, they pay a lot of tax. But there are many people who doesn't pay the tax and they stock the money, become wealthier than the normal people. And they have more purchasing power. So this kind of income inequalities may come. The objective of demonetization is to cut off that and balance it. That was a good objective, but when we checked out, the whole money came back. That according to RBI numbers. So I can say that the delay, the system was not proper. People got enough time to think about it. How to convert black money into white money. 2,500 per day was the restriction, and they manipulated that. I can say that. That's how I personally view that. Is it clear, Somnadh?
Does a firm does not have its control over its products, price of its products?
Yeah. You're asking me, right? Yeah. She said, maybe to change the question, does the firm have control on pricing the product or not?
Hmm.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, if it is an imperfect market, they have the control. They can dictate the price. Okay? They are the price givers. In imperfect market, that it be monopoly, duopoly, oligopoly, or monopolistic competition also, or bilateral monopoly. They dictate price, they dictate terms, they are price givers. Okay? They are not price takers, they are price givers. Buyers are price takers, sellers are price givers. But in a perfect market and pure market, sellers are price takers. Market determines the price. Law of demand is strictly applicable and everyone takes the price fixed by the market. In perfect and pure, yeah, I don't have any control as a seller. In imperfect, I always have this control. Yeah?
Economics means allocation of resources, but after some time, all the resources is get over, then how will be the supply of goods will be proceed?
That is the beauty of doing business. When public sector banks are almost dominating in India, Global Trust Bank is one which brought technology in Indian banking system. And they are almost grabbing the whole customers. I personally thought that this is the end of public sector banking. Then followed by ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, everyone started computer-based banking services. So this made all public sector banks to rethink about the way they are selling. So they offered old people, they cannot know how to use computer. They are offered VRS. New people were taken and they transformed. In Andhra, you can say the whole Andhra economy is struggling right now because there is no construction is in stall. Because of lack of supply of one of the major input, that is sand. Sand supply is not there and there is no alternate supply. And they also had some alternate like stone crush, but that is also exhausted. It is not, when sand was not available, they shifted to the stone crush. Now they are using some alternatives. So maybe, yeah, according to you, the business does not stop. The business may be in a still position or it will pause for a while, they get the alternatives and so on, the business will be definitely hit. I agree with you. But when the resource gets exhausted, natural resource or human resource, monetary resource, whatever, it gets exhausted, the only thing is you will have to find an alternative. Till that time, you will have some gap. Okay?
How the tax system is affected on economy?
Economy, you're saying? So what is the impact of tax? Tax obviously hits business, hits the profits and revenues of business, not only profits and revenues of business, but the point here is where the tax is going. The incidence of taxation is on the seller or buyer. Okay, say for example, a product price is 100 rupees and the taxation right now, it is, there is no tax on that product, and now there is a tax on that, say 10%. So 10% of 100 rupees should be 110, right? So if the seller absorbs that impact of tax, he will retain the price as 100 rupees. Okay, he will digest that impact and makes the customers happy. So in that case, profits or revenues of the firms or sellers will be hit. They will be in trouble. They will come down. The second could be, he will pass on the whole incidence of tax on public. How? Product price is 10 rupees. I'm sorry, 100 rupees, 10 rupees tax. Now the price goes up from 100 to 110. So the incidence of taxation is on consumers or buyers. He is happy. The third one could be, partially he will take, partially he will give. 5 rupees I will take the burden, I will cut down my profits. 5 rupees I will pass on to the public. So definitely impact of tax is there. See, very recently, Nirmala Sitaraman, she cut down the tax rate from 30% to 25% to encourage people with low investments. That obviously encourages them to do more business.
So, there's a question from our friend.
Who is that?
Rajeshwari.
Rajeshwari. Where are you, Rajeshwari? Yeah, what's your question?
Why RBI prints limited money in the country? Why they not print more money and makes everyone rich?
Fine. This is a little out of the box question, I should say that, but still I answer that. It is all about money is not, please, money is not printed just like that. Okay? It is printed against precious reserves, that is gold and foreign currency reserves. Okay, as a multiple of that. It happened in Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe government wanted to make everyone rich and they just printed the money and they gave it. And everyone is rich. Even if I have to go to a saloon and have my shave for the video shoot, I have to pay millions of dollars because everyone has money. You got my point? So that's how money supply works. That's a different context. I hope I answered your question.
Among all the markets which you have learned, which type of market is mostly practiced and least practiced in India? Right?
Whose question? Srujana, please.
Sir, among all the market types which you have learned till now, which type of market is mostly practiced and which type is least practiced in India, and what are the reasons for that?
Okay. So, sir, it's very easy to say perfect market, imperfect market, but what exactly is happening in India or USA? Where are they? Can we see that? Obviously. In India, we have perfect markets, imperfect markets. All types of markets are there. Because market is for a product. In one country, we don't have one product. So we cannot say perfect markets, all markets in India perfect, all markets in UAE are imperfect. We cannot say that. That all depends. For example, if you take telecom companies in UAE, Abu Dhabi, Dubai, Sharjah and so on, you have only two telecom companies. One is Etisalat, the other one is Jio. These are the two only sellers owned by the government there, the kings. Okay? So in that case, it's an imperfect market there. In India also, you have an imperfect market. Indian Railways, you take Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. You have, it is a monopoly. It is the only one. Of course, it works for government. You have Uranium Corporation of India Limited. Yes, it's a monopoly. IRCTC is there. It offers railways related services, including ticket booking and inside services in each and every train. Now they're extending it to private lines also. That is also monopoly. That is an imperfect. But if you take any other market like automobile or smartphone mobile market, or rice market, vegetables market and so on, yeah, it is absolutely perfect. Government doesn't intervene unless and until it is required. Okay, in China also you have a mix of these things. In US also you have a mix of these things. It all depends on the product. Product to product we have to verify. Okay? Again, it's a little out of the box, like Rajeshwari, but still I answer that. Inflation is all about prices, increase in demand. But the question is why demand is increasing. Like I was answering her, demand is increasing because your income levels are increasing. When your income levels are increasing, your purchasing power increases. That leads to inflation. Inflation is a problem to many countries, but some countries are okay. But countries which are looking at high GDP growth kind of thing, they always want low inflation, okay? At least single digit inflation, less than 10%. But Indian administrators, they always wanted inflation less than 5%. It is easy to control. The point is easy to control. If it goes to 10% or beyond that, it will be very difficult to control.
Is equilibrium is necessary for the oligopoly market?
The point here is some people may have some misapprehension that because one of you are asking, Asha was asking me, can the sellers control the price? I was telling in monopoly you can, but it does not mean that seller can price a product at any level. He will also test the market. He will also test the market. If the people are able to take the product at the desired price, he will test it, he will run. If it goes beyond that, people will not buy. Okay? So to what extent the maximum demand is there at a given price, that is the equilibrium. So that's how equilibrium point is there. Even if you take for a perfect market, buyers want the lowest price, sellers or suppliers want the highest price. So there will be equilibrium somewhere between these two. Each and every market has equilibrium, but factors influencing are different. Okay?
We know each and every factor which influences demand and supply of a product, but why still some business getting profits and why still some business are getting loss?
See, that's what someone is asking, business and economics, whose question was that? Why should we take business economics? You asked that. And who said business environment and business economics? You only. I think there lies it. Doing business is different. Economics is different. You joined MBA program, Masters in Management here. There are some economic factors also. Nearness to you, quality of education, fee, hostel, everything you would have counted. So learning is different, economics is different. So that way business is completely different from economics. While doing business, you need economics. It's not that economics is there, you are doing business. It is that way. Okay.
Question from Yatish.
Yatish, where are you?
As we know the law of demand. But in case of Christmas trees, as the price increases, demand also increases. Why is it violated?
Sorry, come again.
As we know, law of demand, in case of Christmas trees, the price of Christmas trees increases, demand also increases. Why it violates law of demand?
Okay. Yeah. I mean, his question is, in the festive mood, in the festive season, may not be Christmas, everything. Crackers, last day you should check the prices. On Diwali, in Vijayanagaram and Vizag, you know, 10 rupees a pack will go for even 1000 rupees also. I've seen that. Yeah, that is beyond MRP. MRP of a firework is very high, right? These guys will sell even more than that also. So, that is an exemption. These are the daily needed goods kind of thing. Given paradox, given goods to discuss. So, daily needed products, it could be food items, transportation, telephone services, monthly bills of telephone, electricity bills, whatever may be the electricity price, we have to. In the festive mood, whatever may be the price, you have to. When Hudhud came, water bottle was sold for 100 rupees, even 200 rupees. You can't say no, you need it. Maybe festive season, yeah, sir, you are talking about daily needs. When festive season, Christmas tree or fireworks, it's not mandatory. But you have money. When you have money, it is mandatory, it becomes mandatory. So I'm willing to pay and I want to make myself and my family joyful. This once in a while, once in a year. So I'm ready to spend it. So that makes someone to violate the law of demand.
What's the difference between US economy and Indian economy?
Of course. First of all, both of them are the largest democratic countries, unlike China or Russia. They are different patterns. Being democratic, we excelled in business also. When I was very new to teaching career, India hardly had 1%, less than 1% in the global trade. In the global trade, its share is hardly 1% or less than 1%. Now it has reached to a substantial amount that it is part of BRICS economies. You know, BRICS. So five economies are growing at a larger rate or higher rate than USA. But still, the size of the economy is measured in terms of GDP. So, post-liberalization, it happened, it started, and it took its pace in the times of Modi, okay? And it will continue, whoever comes to power, it continues like that. When you look at economy, it is growing, but it's all about the stakeholders, participants, regulators and controllers. Americans are far superior because they are the capitalists. If there is a country which completely gives value for money than anything else, including human beings, it is America. Capitalistic form. Capitalists, they talk like that. But India, we don't talk like that. We want human values. We want social values. We want money. We want respect. We want family. We want everyone to live happily. Okay? But capitalists, they praise the rich. Rich is always revered there. They don't like poor people. Okay? So that kind of class differences are there. But in terms of GDP, yeah, we are growing. We have beaten France. We are close to top 5. And we'll be reaching top 3 also. Maybe the day will come, we'll be the largest economy in the world in terms of GDP. We are close to that. We are not far away. Maybe 5 years from now onwards, 2024-25, we should be that. Because India is the biggest consumer market, even after China. Population.
Sir, in the year 1975, our Prime Minister Indira Gandhi has declared emergency in our country. It makes some good for some business. It makes some bad for some business. What is emergency mean?
Emergency means things are completely seized. Now I'm hearing that in Andhra, newspapers will be shut down. If they write against or talk against the government. The emergency is also like that. If someone is talking, the most affected is the media. Business will continue to happen. See, business people, as you told me, ask me, what happens if the natural resources get exhausted? Business people, they want money. Paisa chahiye bas. They are very good in making money. Even if the government is not there, business will be there. Why emergency? The government, you take Iraq, you take Afghanistan, they are struggling, they are dying, but still business is there. Okay? One last question, we are running out of time.
So, what are the different ways that firm can compete on other than product specialization?
You are doing a research or what? You are hitting me directly. Okay. Product specialization. Actually, the product should be different. It should be unique or specialized. But nowadays, people are branding the product as a special product through promotions, ads. Okay? Like Parley. Suna to hua. Actually, that was a great ad I had seen. People have ignored what was Parley. And they have used this strategy and making that as a special product. So now in India, nationalism or patriotism is increasing. Now people are producing or selling or supplying their product by saying that this is Indian. It was made in India. Let us be part of Make in India. So my point here is defining specialization. Apart from specialization, yeah, there are many low price, better quality, easy to access, customer satisfaction. There are many companies which doesn't go for advertisements. They don't spend huge money on advertisements, but still they sell a lot. Yeah, there. I think businessmen will tell that in the specific product. You need not be specialized based on the physical features of the product. Of course, that is one of them. You have many. Okay, friends, I need to stop here. The next session will be on. Thanks for your wonderful participation. Thank you all.
I would like to thank Dr. Raju Indukoori sir for sharing the knowledge with us and enlightening us. The session is very helpful for us to understand business economics in the real world. I would like to thank the students who came forward to ask the questions. And finally, I would like to thank all the students for attending the session and making this a success. So we are looking forward for further more sessions like this. Thank you everyone and have a good day.